Well, human rights group Amnesty International has condemned Tanzania's plans to hunt down and arrest suspected homosexuals from next week already. Anti-homosexual sentiment is indeed rife in Tanzania right now, forcing most gays, lesbians and other sexual minorities to live in secrecy. Under British colonial-era laws, homosexuality is illegal in Tanzania, with same-sex acts between men punishable by maximum life sentence. For reaction on that story, we're joined by Access Chapter 2, that's Steve Letsike, via Skype. Good afternoon, Steve, and thank you so much for your time on the SABC News Desk.
Good afternoon, Kishni, and good afternoon to your viewers.
Steve, I just want to garner your initial reaction to the move by Tanzania now to clamp down on the LGBTI community there.
Well, Kishni, we actually condemn, the witch hunt in Tanzania because really it does put lives at stake. It is leaving many LGBTI persons, living in fear for their lives because of what the government has pledged to do in the arrest and also what might subject to them at the cost of life.
Steve, when it comes to the treatment of those that are detained by Tanzanian authorities, do you have information from people who have come to you? Or you can enlighten us on how they are treated once they are detained.
First, we know that, this is not new. In 2015, Tanzania had rapidly, started becoming a hostile state for LGBTI persons. And we've seen recently with the arrest of many LGBTI persons and also human rights advocate like Sibongi Lendashe, who's a South African lawyer a couple of months ago, that happened in Tanzania. But what we know is that this persecution, this attacks and arrest will lead in the cost of life. People are attacked in jail. People are examined. This annual examination that governments would also do. This is state sponsored homophobia and transphobia against LGBTI persons, which Tanzania has committed to do.
All right, Steve, I just want to garner your thoughts on this one. How serious do you think South Africa is right now on protecting gay rights on the continent? We do seem to be walking a tightrope between having strong constitutional commitment on paper to protecting gay rights, but we do have to balance this with solidarity with the largely homophobic rest of Africa. About 38 of Africa's 55 states still criminalize homosexuality. And I recall that we took a very quiet diplomatic approach on Uganda's anti-gay bill a few years ago. What kind of response would you like to see from the South African government on what's happening in Tanzania when it comes to the LGBTI community and this particular legislation that's expected to roll out?
Well, I think it's quite critical to realize and note that we actually have, a president who cares for the citizens of the country and who cares for human rights. And I think we need to pride ourselves with that. President Ramaphosa has spoken, for a number of times since he took office as the president, in terms of protecting LGBTI persons, and now recently also raising these concerns in the last 2 days, gender-based violence summit that took place. But what we want to see, because I think our history, in protecting LGBTI persons have been actually dwindling. We have, of course, the Constitution and many policies that protect LGBTI persons, but it's not necessarily fully translated into a lived reality for many in South Africa. Indeed, a couple of years ago, we were diplomatic in our approach with Uganda and in many of the countries. But we want a very bold leadership. We want President Ramaphosa to speak out. We want Minister Sisulu, who's our foreign minister, to speak out really about our own international commitment on the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, but also in the African Charter that speaks to right to life, right to privacy, and also ensuring that human rights are not violated in the region. That's part of building open society in the region, and that's also part of our own promotion of international laws. So that's what we want from our current leadership, and I think that's what we ask for our president as well.
Steve, can you quickly enlighten us on what the major issues for LGBTI rights are on a global scale? I mean, eradicating persecution and prosecution, of course, based on sexual orientation, a big one, protection in law from hate crimes and hate propaganda, and then ensuring equal rights and privileges when it comes to issues of marriage, medical decision-making, wills, estates, etc.
I mean, 72 countries across the globe still criminalize homosexual act. And I think that on its own then, of course, perpetuate other discrimination on, you know, the right to work policy, the right to education, the right to access, equal access to health, and many challenges that we've seen over time. Kishni, it's very important because if we do not respect the identity of the individual and also the rights to privacy, that on its own impacts the economic, social, and political right of the individual. It denies the person their active role as a citizen and their active role in the families where they belong. We've seen many challenges where people are rejected over by their own families, by their own friends, by their own communities because they identify as either lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, or intersex. So these are some of the challenges we've seen in the country where we are. There's a rise of homelessness. There's a rise of suicide. And, I mean, just this weekend, two people committed suicide because they have been found to either be coming out from their own to their families and so forth. So these are challenges that we really are confronted with. Now, when we talk for countries like Tanzania that is still criminalizing homosexual acts, how much more do we want to see people hiding, to want to see people denied just being human and the existence in their own lives? We've seen in both Tanzania, currently Tanzania, and Uganda, because Uganda has now also looking at the list of LGBTI persons, LGBTI organizations and their funders, and they're actually doing the witch hunt in both Uganda and Tanzania.
Access Chapter 2, Steve Letsike joining us there via Skype connection. Thank you, Steve, for your time on the SABC News Desk. Time to take a short break. I'll be back with more news after this.